You may remember it as the Student Association, the General Student Council, or the Association of Student Representatives. Today, the Student Government Association advocates for the development and advancement of student interests both inside and outside of the university community. I sat down with outgoing SGA President Ty Tinker and incoming SGA President Claire Carlson to discuss the role of student government on Trinity's campus for this decade and beyond. You know, one of the things that SGA does is to try and maintain a positive and informed relationship between the student body and university administration. So I'd just like to talk with both of you a little bit. How does this kind of collaboration come about?
So a lot of people don't know all the different things that SGA can do. And we have a link to a lot of different administrators on campus and different people who are able to help us achieve a lot of different things. But on top of that, we have access to allocating the student activity funds and other important things like that. So by being a representative, you have access to all of those things and you're able to represent people's interests in terms of funding different events or speakers or representing other interests by getting things done on campus.
At the beginning of every single meeting, which we have weekly and sometimes more often, we have a climate check, which is an open invitation to the entire campus, anybody, to come in and field discussion questions, any complaints or compliments that you may have. Basically anything that's going on, because we have the links to the people who can solve the problems. Sometimes there's facility issues that nobody knows about until they're brought up in student government. So I really, in addition to increasing engagement, just would love to see more folks at these climate checks to give us the ability to understand what's truly impacting people and how, and to see the faces of the people that it is impacting.
Mm-hmm. So we've had student government since the 1920s. It is not always the same. There are all kinds of changes to make it work more effectively. What's the biggest change happening right now?
Yeah, well, one of the most important changes that student government is experiencing, as are the rest of clubs on campus, is a change in the election cycle. We are currently working from January until January. However, come this fall, we're going to be working on the academic year, meaning that Claire's only going to be president for one semester and already is looking forward to a new election cycle by the end of this semester.
Yeah, so I've got a short term, so trying to use it efficiently.
All right.
Claire, could you talk a little bit about, you know, the day in the life of a student senator, or what you think it's going to be like for you, the pace of activity, the things going on that others may not see?
Yeah. One thing that a lot of people don't recognize that we have is committees within SGA, and that's kind of where most of the day-to-day work is going to happen. So we have like a finance committee, we have a dining committee, we have a diversity committee, and all of those committees are kind of working on their own each day to get things done all in their own little realms. So we might have the dining committee going down to maybe or talking with Airmark to get more vegetarian or cultural food on campus. And we have other organizations working elsewhere to register voters and stuff on campus. So even though they're all kind of different things, it really comes together under the SGA umbrella.
What are some of the maybe myths or assumptions about SGA you would like people to get right as they think about why it matters?
I think that a lot of people assume that SGA doesn't really have any real power to make any changes on campus. But as I've already mentioned, we have access to a lot of different things like the Student Activities Fund and links to different administration and faculty members that can kind of help us make changes on campus in a positive manner. I hope that people recognize that their vote really does matter. By voting for people that represent their best interests, they can ensure that their voice is heard on campus.
And I agree completely with everything that Claire said. In addition, I think if you feel as though you don't have the loudest voice right now, or if your concerns aren't being heard, then find SGA, whether it's through the climate checks, as I mentioned earlier, or whether it's through simply voting for your class representatives, or the biggest change you can make is running for senator or running for one of these positions like president or vice president. That is the best way to make change on campus. Claire will be a fantastic leader for this semester. Engage with SGA, engage with her, engage with your senators, find a way to find SGA.
Beyond policies and procedures, the Student Government Association prepares students for leadership roles. They work with diverse populations on local and global issues, and they take steps to understand the passion-driven challenges of representation and advocacy. How did Trinity prepare you to become a leader? Please share your stories with me. I love hearing from Trinity students, colleagues, and alumni. As change makers in our communities and our world, we will accelerate what's next for Trinity. We are a force in motion.